this guy. Please tell us why you had to hide away for so long.
Hello. Welcome back to another video. So I've done the complete polar opposite to what I first thought this channel would be about, kind of reviewing modern style cars, and jump behind the wheel of this. This car's a Jaguar E-Type Series 1, 4.2, finished in opalescent dark blue with a lovely grey interior to match. It's the original spec of the car when it left the factory. It's been fully restored and is now for sale with the people who have lent me this car very kindly, E-Type UK. So today I'm going to be driving this car to my favourite bakery. I thought, what better opportunity to perform very British style video than to take one of Britain's most incredible and beautiful cars to my favourite bakery. So we've started down in Hadlow, where E-Type UK is based, and we're going to be driving up to Edenbridge, where my favourite bakery is based. So, first impressions, I mean, first of all, what a brilliant experience, and I'm so pleased to be able to bring this kind of content to you. I've been doing a lot of stuff with E-Type UK over the years, but never really got behind the wheel of one of their showroom cars. So today it's obviously extremely grateful for them giving me the opportunity to really test this car out and see what it's like to drive one, because, I mean, it's a lot of people's bucket, this car. And I know for a fact that there's loads of people on my Instagram or through my family even that would be very jealous of this experience. But I mean, what an experience to have and enjoy, and the sun's out, literally couldn't ask for a better day to do it really. And I mean, in terms of the driving experience, I just feel so relaxed. I was a bit worried getting in because obviously this car's kind of circa £200,000 if you were to put it for sale, like E-Type UK have. And obviously the cars I've driven before probably had a maximum value of about £110,000, so I know it's only kind of 90k jump, but with something that's so hard to restore or bring back to life if something does go wrong, I was always going to be a bit nervous getting behind the wheel. But I mean, this is just lovely. I mean, the grey interior to match the paint outside is just pleasant. It's like lovely to look at. It's got these lovely dials in front, and most of the car's been kept completely original because there's loads of upgrades you can do on E-Types now with modern technology and even exhausts and things like this, or performance to the engine. But this one's been kept relatively stock. It's got a few bits and bobs here and there on the interior, but nothing that kind of suggests, oh, you've ruined the car, it's not how it should be, you should have kept it classic, original, that's how everyone loved it back in the day. But this one is a perfect example of showing that you can still love and appreciate a car of this age, even in this modern era of 2022. It's funny as well, because I was expecting to get in this car and feel like I was massive on the road, and I think because you can see all the way down that bonnet, it really helps you grasp almost automatically how wide and long the car is, because you're based pretty much in the centre of the car. And the driving position's perfect, so I haven't really got to adapt anything. My legs are in great shape, good position, great shape. I don't even go to the gym. But yeah, no, it's just a brilliant little experience to get behind the wheel of this, right? I've always had an itch for a classic car to one day hopefully own one. And this is not helping my itch. Just such a brilliant experience. I think I can just picture myself just using it at the weekend. To be honest, you know what I'm like, if I get a car, I'm in it all the time, so I probably use it way more than the weekend. But we're just coming up to the top of Hyde Hill, which has a magnificent view. Around the bend, and then I'll show you a little drone clip now of the view it does have. It's just phenomenal. See for miles. The other thing you've got to love about classic car experiences is the smell. I think as a petrol head that grew up in the 90s and obviously into the early noughties, if you like, it's just the smell of that petrol engine and just all the fumes. I think a lot of people would say that it's a bit too much and very goes straight up to your head, but I think it's just such a brilliant way to experience a car when you can smell everything, you can hear everything, and it's just, yeah, it's just brilliant. I think anyone in the same position as me would say that the smell is almost part of the experience of driving something at this age. I think if you haven't got that, it's almost like, why are you driving it? Just gonna open it up a bit. It's just giving me a bit of room in front. Driving a yacht. It's just the way the front nose lifts. When you put your foot down, it's just like, oh, it's captivating. So I think we're about 2 or 3 minutes away from Edenbridge now. I mean, I haven't had any breakfast, so I think a nice finger bun is definitely on the cards. One of my favourites. But yeah, I think pull in, get some cakes, head back up to E-Type UK to conclude the video, and then unfortunately I have to give the keys back, although I'm sure if this video goes down well, they'll give me another opportunity to get behind another car. I'd love to get behind the wheel of an Unleashed, and I think Jack definitely knows that, because I've shot 3 of them now. I've got the pictures here, and those are just stunning, and they're obviously a bit more mechanically engineered to be used as a modern car, I guess, so it'd definitely be nice to experience one of those and compare the differences between something that's almost completely original and something that's obviously been tweaked and tinkered with for modern day use. So yeah, I'll have to ask very politely on that one, I think. Massive thanks again for them to let me use the car to go do my cake shopping for the Jubilee weekend. But yeah, hopefully in the near future I'll be able to get behind the wheel of one of their Unleashed models to see what the difference is once it's been tweaked a little. And do like and subscribe, because I've got plenty of videos and ideas in mind to come in the future, including one that I'm probably filming as we speak with a rather special car. So keep your eyes peeled for that on my Instagram as well. And until next time, I hand the keys back and that's goodbye.